shoot more places, you know? So there ended up being eight people or eight different shoots in the Gulf of California. New York had quite a few as well, obviously. But there were surprises. Alaska and Maine had the most unbelievable playwright. And it didn't surprise me in a way because they're so on the edge of wilderness, and Alaska has four men to every woman, so it's no wonder that there's a ultimately the story is really is how I relate to people. And once I got a certain occupation or type, I try not to repeat the same story, you know. So if the stories were different, and in many cases in New York on Greenwich Avenue, I got two shoots, the same day. I got the same, two guys from Chester, Virginia, best friends, but it seemed like I had, and that happened in Atlanta. There were two interracial couples that wrote to me, and their stories were so different, but equally compelling. So I shot them both, and they both made the book. And in more cases than not, where I had some question as to who to include, I just said, shoot them both, and we'll worry about it later. And almost every time, both made the book. So, it just, the stories. The question was, the editing process. How many images did I shoot of everybody? How many did I supply to the publisher? And what was that process like? I tended to photograph anywhere from 150 to 600 images, for each shoot. And it would, usually be no more than a couple hours of shooting. But the fact that it was digital, and I wasn't worried about, a dollar sign every time I hit that button. I shot more than I usually did in the past, but it served me well. I've gotten very good at editing my own work in the many years that I've been at it. And the designer on the book, Greg Wakabayashi, is just, I'm in awe of his talent. He used to work with Avanon, and he always, I would supply him with anywhere from 1 to 5 pictures for each shoot, I would say. And he always came back to me with what I considered the best photo, from a photography standpoint. And I think that is a real awesome thing and rare thing to have with a photo editor that's deciding on your book. I mean, previously in all editorial jobs I've never had somebody pick those best pictures. So I was thrilled. And he never once asked me for more pictures. He talks about, American politics and religions and places and how they're treated in high school, and that's unique to our country. But what I found is that there were as many stories as there are in the straight community. There's just so much. I mean, there certainly could be a volume 2 and volume 3 of just Gay in America, other gay men. It's never ending. There's wonderful stories out there that we all can learn from, and as gay men can appreciate, and I think straight people can learn from this too. It's like you hold a mirror up to other people when you storytell, that's like glad when they had him. They told me that's the number one thing that affects people's attitudes about homophobia, or is knowing somebody. It changes their mind. And Cuomo's, Sandra Lee's, brother's gay, and now he's a huge advocate. I think the more that people come out and are honest with themselves, it can't help but foster that change. I'm sure. They're just different than somebody else. The more we can do to share our stories, I think we combat that. But it's human nature in general too, to bully and to pick out people that are different than you. So it's tough. Society's tough, and it doesn't doesn't always get better. Our society is a harsh place, so you gotta learn to love yourself and be strong with yourself, and then you can face those outside forces, with strength. And it takes parents to, educate their kids, because ultimately, they have so much to do with how a child deals with those outside forces and those bullies. And if you're loved from the beginning, I think you can deal with them. It's a hard, tough thing out there. And there's also, I love the It Gets Better project. I think it's so important in how it's helped so many people. But in the same breath, I find how it's been slightly hijacked by so many politicians and people that want to bond with the liberal community, and they just make a video that reinforces that it sucks to be gay. sharing my gay world